Would you like to have the sun here with us on Earth? If you think that's an outlandish idea that can never happen, China is here to prove you wrong. The nation has just replicated the star at the center of the solar system by producing a new nuclear sun. But how does China's new nuclear sun replica work?
But more importantly, is China biting off more than it can chew?
And should you be afraid of things getting out of hand? The sun is a sort of life lying at the heart of the solar system. It is by far the largest object, accounting for 99.8% of the solar system's mass, with a diameter that's roughly 109 times the diameter of the Earth. The sun can contain about 1 million of our planets. The surface of the sun is about 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 5,500 degrees Celsius, but the core is far hotter, reaching more than 27 million degrees Fahrenheit or 15 million degrees Celsius. One would need to explode 100 billion tons of dynamite every second to match the energy produced by the sun. The sun is one of more than 100 billion stars in the Milky Way. It orbits some at 25,000 light-years from the galactic core, completing a revolution once every 250 million years. Where stars are concerned, the sun is relatively young, part of a generation of stars known as Population 1, which are relatively rich in elements heavier than helium. It was born about 4.6 billion years ago. However, it has enough fuel to stay active for another 5 billion years. The sun's surface emits about 63 million watts of energy per square meter. By the time the energy reaches the Earth after traveling 150 million kilometers or 93 million miles, it is diminished to 1,370 watts per square meter at the top of the atmosphere directly facing the sun. However, China apparently is not satisfied with the amount of energy it gets from the sun, so it is creating one in its own backyard, and it's more than 5 times hotter than the actual sun. However, all this sun replication comes with a huge bill, $1 trillion. Before we go into how China's artificial sun works, why is the country building one? The aim is to deliver near-limitless clean energy by mimicking the natural reactions occurring within stars. The artificial sun uses the same method as the original sun to produce energy, the holy grail of clean energy production. This is because the process requires no fossil fuels and leaves behind no hazardous waste materials, unlike the nuclear fission process that powers commercial nuclear energy production. Researchers also claim that there is far less risk of an environmental disaster. So, how does China's artificial sun work? It works just like the sun. The solar energy reaching you on Earth is created by nuclear fusion taking place in the sun. Nuclear fusion occurs when protons of hydrogen atoms violently collide in the sun's core and fuse to create a helium atom. This process, known as PP or proton-proton chain reaction, emits stupendous energy deep within its core. The sun fuses about 620 million metric tons of hydrogen every second. The reaction is possible thanks to the extreme pressure and temperature within the core, estimated to be the equivalent of 250 billion atmospheres or 25.33 trillion kilopascals and 15.7 million Kelvin, respectively. The net result is the fusion of 4 protons or hydrogen nuclei into 1 alpha particle, 2 protons and 2 neutrons bound together into a particle identical to a helium nucleus. 2 positrons are released from this process, as well as 2 neutrinos, which change 2 of the protons into neutrons in energy. China's sun was the temperature and pressure within the tokamak to create the conditions necessary for nuclear fusion to occur. The plasma is heated by various means, including radio waves, and is confined within the magnetic field. The aim is to maintain the plasma for as long as possible to allow for sustained nuclear fusion reactions to occur, releasing large amounts of energy in the process. Despite the potential benefits of China's artificial sun, there are also concerns about the risks involved. The extreme temperatures and pressures required for nuclear fusion are difficult to control, and there is always the risk of accidents or equipment failures that could lead to disaster. There are also concerns about the high cost of the project, as well as the environmental impact of such a large-scale endeavor. In conclusion, China's artificial sun is a significant achievement in the field of fusion energy research. The potential benefits of near-limitless clean energy are enormous, and the scientific community is closely watching China's progress in this area. However, there are also significant risks and challenges associated with this project, and it remains to be seen whether China will be able to overcome these obstacles and achieve its goal of delivering clean, sustainable energy for future generations.